Hello. In this video, we will talk about four types of effects of external stimuli on heart: chronotropic, inotropic, dromotropic, and bathymotropic. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. Cardiac tropism describes the effect of external stimuli on the heart. See, the factors acting on the heart affect different parameters of heart functions. So they produce different types of changes in heart activity. These changes are broadly categorized into four types: chronotropic effects, inotropic effects, dromotropic effects, and bathymotropic effects. Here, the meaning of the suffix tropic, which is common for all the words, is change. Now let's see each of them one by one. First, chronotropic effects. Chrono means time. And of course, the most important cardiac parameter related to time is heart rate. That is, how many times the heart beats every minute. So the chronotropy means changes in heart rate. Positive chronotropic means an increase in heart rate. And a negative chronotropic means a decrease in heart rate. Now, we know that heart rate is controlled by the SA node, the pacemaker of the heart. So the factors affecting heart rate acts through the SA node. For example, adrenaline speeds up the SA node and thereby increases the heart rate. So it is called a positive inotropic agent. On the other hand, acetylcholine slows down the SA node. So it decreases heart rate. Or in other words, it produces negative chronotropic action. So these were chronotropic actions. Next, we have inotropic effects. Ino means force, and tropic means change. So the inotropic effect means a change in the force of contraction. Positive inotropic means an increase in the force of contraction, and negative inotropic means decrease in the force of contraction. Now, the main factor determining the contractility is calcium concentration in cardiac muscle. So the factors affecting contractility acts by changing calcium levels in the cardiac muscles. For example, cardiac glycosides like digitalis cause calcium loading in heart muscles. This increases force of contraction, also called positive inotropic action. On the other hand, calcium channel blockers decrease the calcium levels. This leads to a decrease in force of contraction, also called a negative inotropic action. So these were inotropic actions. Next are dromotropic actions. Dromo means running. Okay, but who's running here? Impulse. We know that impulse is generated at SA node, passes through AV node to reach the ventricles. Dromotropic means change in the speed of this impulse conduction through the AV node. Positive dromotropic means increase in the velocity of conduction. And negative dromotropic means decrease in the velocity of the conduction. Obviously, dromotropic effects are produced by acting on the AV node. For example, adrenaline increases the velocity of conduction through the AV node. Thus, it produces positive dromotropic action. And cardiac glycosides decrease the velocity of conduction. Or in other words, they have negative dromotropic action. So these were the dromotropic actions. Now the final one, bathymotropic actions. Bathymo means threshold. Here it's the threshold for action potential that we are talking about. This bathymotropic action means changes in the excitability of cardiac muscles. Positive bathymotropic means increase in excitability, and negative bathymotropic means decreased excitability. Now, the excitability depends on the resting membrane potential. The closer it is to the threshold, the easier it is to reach it and get excited. The bathymotropic effects are produced by altering resting membrane potential. For example, adrenaline brings the resting membrane potential close to the threshold. This makes the cell easily excitable, or in other words, adrenaline produces positive bathymotropic action. On the other hand, acetylcholine produces the opposite effect. So it has negative bathymotropic action. So these were all the actions on the heart. Now let's have a quick summary. Chronotropic action means a change in heart rate. It is produced by action on SA node. Inotropic action means a change in contractility. It is produced by changes in calcium level inside the cardiac muscle. Thromotropic action means a change in impulse conduction through the AV node. And of course, they are produced by action on the AV node. Finally, the bathymotropic action means a change in excitability. It is produced by altering resting membrane potential. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.